sugar. So let's start by looking at exactly what sugar is. Well, sugar is a simple carbohydrate consisting of a glucose molecule and a fructose molecule. Sugar, also known as sucrose, is derived from sugar cane and sugar beets, and it is also found naturally in some foods such as fruits and honey. So what happens to sugar in our body? Well, when we eat sugar, it gets digested in the small intestine, where an enzyme called sucrase comes in and splits the bond between the fructose and the glucose molecules. These molecules then get sent to the liver. In the liver, fructose is then transformed in three different ways. It can be converted to glucose, where it can be used as energy for cells. It can be converted to glycogen and stored in the liver for later use as energy. Or it can be converted to and eventually stored as fat. In the liver, glucose has three different destinations. It can be sent into the bloodstream and be used as immediate energy for cells. It can be converted into glycogen and stored in the muscles or liver, or it too can be converted to and stored as fat. If glucose is sent into the bloodstream, the pancreas is signaled to release the hormone insulin. Insulin travels to cells and tells the cells, open up, let the glucose in. And as the cells let the glucose in, the pancreas then slows down the release of insulin. So far, it seems as if sugar is not bad for you. I mean, it provides energy. But if you look online, you'll find all kinds of articles and research claiming that sugar is a bad boy nutritionally. Well, that's true to a large extent. But the reason is because we abuse our bodies with added sugar intake, not the natural sugar found in fruits. Added sugar can be found in so many food items we consume, from breads to cereals to health bars and all of the desserts we eat. In fact, the American Heart Association recommends the maximum amount of added sugars you should eat in a day be around 37.5 grams, or 150 calories for men, and 25 grams, or 100 calories for women. The average American consumes 96 grams, or 385 calories, of added sugar per day. There are many health issues that have arisen from all this sugar consumption. The main two issues are insulin production and obesity. You see, added sugar gets digested quickly, and that means it doesn't make you full, and it leaves you wanting more. Rapid digestion leads to overconsumption, which leads to gaining weight, which leads to a ton of health risks. As we eat more and more added sugar, insulin production skyrockets, putting a lot of stress on the pancreas, possibly causing the organ to become damaged. And this onslaught of sugar consumption can lead to type 2 diabetes. Folks, the bottom line is moderation. Check out food labels and see how much sugar the foods you're eating have in them. Try and keep that amount at or under the American Heart Association's daily recommendations. And don't be afraid of fruits because they have sugar in them. Fruits are filled with vitamins, minerals, fiber, antioxidants, and water. All important things for health. Moderation. Always about moderation.